Introduce myself?
Yeah, not like you.
It's come to that, huh? Okay. Bob Redford, I'm in All Is Lost.
Working with Robert Redford was a dream come true, and Robert Redford is an icon of independent filmmaking as well as an actor.
The wealth and length of his career and the experiences that he's had, he's just a complete professional.
The role, the main character of our man, had to be sort of in his, you know, 70s. It was really a foundation of the project for me, was that it was someone, you know, in the last couple chapters of their life.
It was special for me to do at this point in my life because it was so innovative and different. And also as an actor, that's how I started my career as an actor. And that's probably still the best love of my life.
In a weird way, when I kind of brought together all the different elements and looked at it, there really only was literally one person, you know, who could help us get the film made and then, you know, fulfilled all the creative elements I was looking for. And it came down to him. and luckily, within about 2 or 3 days of us giving him the script, he had gotten back to us and said that he wanted to meet with me.
He took a meeting with JC, and JC called me afterwards and said, listen, it's a very JC phrase, he says, we hugged it out, and he said he wants to do the movie, and all he needed to do was make sure I wasn't a crazy person, and I guess he decided I'm not crazy.
But the fact that he came to me and said, look, I wrote this with you in mind, that touched me. And when I read it, I thought, well, this is something exciting for me to do at this point in my life.
He admittedly, to me, has said that he was ready to just get back to purely acting. And as he was kind of making that decision in his career, luckily I kind of converged with this script on his desk. And he's always been drawn to sort of very difficult material.
I really believe that JC wrote this script with Bob in mind, and I don't think that, you know, Neal, JC, or I could imagine anybody else in this role. So for us, it was the biggest accomplishment.
There are really only so many people, you know, who are in their late 70s or mid 70s or 70s at all that could withstand, you know, the physical and frankly the emotional workout, you know, that this project was going to take.
And I guess something just kicked into gear, and I thought, well, I'll do what I can. And when I did this much, he said, gee, it was more than I thought. Well, maybe we'll do an extra bit. And I said, well, yeah, I can do that. And then a little extra. Next thing you know, I was doing most of the stuff. You have to somehow convey his indecision, his sudden burst of thought and solution, his wondering whether it's all worth it, wondering why it's happening to him. All these things are at play throughout the film, but you can only convey them with thinking. So for me, that's a wonderful challenge as an actor. You have to be completely involved in your character.
All the emotion and all the action that's happening is just happening on his face.
Bob came into the film very much saying, I believe in JC's vision. I believe in the story that he wants to tell here. I am not interested in being the director on this film. I'm not interested in being the writer on this film.
JC and Bob on set has been very interesting. You know, Bob's a director, so JC had to figure out how much Bob was going to give himself over to him, and we didn't know that.
The best way I can serve this man and his vision is to just give myself over to him completely. Don't look at any film, don't look at any dailies, don't look at the monitor, just be in the character and do what you have to do. And that was the right thing to do. It felt good.
I think it was a lot, said a lot about how Bob approached this movie, which was he put himself in JC's hands.
But to his amazing credit, he had just come off directing a film, and I think, you know, he was really looking forward to fully committing himself just as an actor.